Today's topic is direct and indirect taxes. Now, what are the direct taxes? Income tax, corporation tax, and wealth tax are major direct taxes. Whereas central sales tax, central excise, service tax, and customs law are major indirect taxes. Besides these, there are some other indirect taxes like the octroi, entry tax, luxury tax, etc. Coming to the direct taxes, the central government revenue is about 56% of the total tax revenue, whereas in the indirect taxes, the central government revenue is about 44% of the total tax revenue. The direct taxes are paid directly to the government by the person liable to pay tax, and indirect taxes are paid to government by one person, but he recovers the same from another person. Thus, the person who actually bears the tax burden, the ultimate consumer, pays it indirectly to the government through some other person. Let's define the direct and indirect taxes. Direct taxes are those taxes which the taxpayer pays directly from his income or wealth or its estate. Whereas indirect taxes are those which the taxpayer pays indirectly, that is, while purchasing goods and commodities, paying for service, etc. Broadly speaking, the direct taxes are those which are paid after the income reaches the hands of the taxpayers, whereas the indirect taxes are paid before the goods and services reach the taxpayer. Important direct taxes are income tax, gift tax, and wealth tax, expenditure tax, etc. The important indirect taxes are central excise duty, the duty on manufacture, customs, duty on imports and exports, sales tax, octroi tax, entry tax, service tax, etc. What are the advantages of direct taxes? The first one is psychological resistance. It is psychologically very difficult for a person to pay some amount after it is received in his hands. Hence, there is a psychological resistance. This is the reason why every Income Tax Act is widening the scope of tax deduction at source, or TDS and TCS. Thus, a direct tax is converted to an indirect tax. Second, tax evasion is comparatively more in direct taxes where it is an unorganized sector since control is difficult. Thirdly, collection cost of direct taxes as percentage of tax collected are higher in indirect taxes compared to direct taxes. Next, direct taxes can control such wasteful expenditure only indirectly by taxing higher income group people. And last, government can judiciously use the direct taxes to support development in desirable areas while discouraging it in others. Example, tax incentives for industries in backward areas, infrastructure development, etc. The advantages of indirect taxes. Then we come to direct disadvantages of direct taxes. The indirect taxes are progressive as they depend on paying capacity. Rich person is taxed more compared to the poor person. The direct taxes do not affect prices of goods and services. Third, high income tax rates increases tax evasion and hawala transactions. Direct taxes do not have such effect, and direct taxes are not inflationary. The disadvantages of indirect taxes are that, first, indirect taxes increase the prices of products and hence are often perceived as inflationary. High customs duty and excise duty increases cost of modern machinery and technology. Third, high customs or excise duty increases smuggling, hawala trade and mafia gangs, which is harmful in many ways. Similarly, high excise duty too causes evasion. Fourth, tax on goods and services increases its prices, which reduces demand of goods and services. Lesser demand means lower growth of industrialization. And last, indirect taxes do not depend on paying capacity. Since the indirect tax is uniform, the tax payable on commodity is same, whether it is purchased by a poor man or a rich person. Hence, the indirect taxes are termed as regressive.